I said good day, sir!
Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the defense, powered by Razor, as well as BenQ Part 2 of your VOD Infused versus Mouse Sports. I will go a little bit slower, but we don't have time! Into the game is where we go, where everyone has already kicked off. Let me get some my co-commentators and volume as well. Her name is Siri. I'll introduce her, but it's already happened four times today. And here's our first blood in the bottom lane, not being missed. 1-4-3-7. Everyone's casting their spells as agreed by the players. And this will be the death of 1-4-3-7. Taking a little bit longer to do it. But first blood gets to go with the Juggernaut. And welcome, Siri, back into the game, which won't crash. I intended that satirically.
Thank you, Toby. Hello again for the fourth time.
Hello.
It's interesting to see that, you know, they are going to transition this tri-lane middle. I think that there's going to be just a lot of action, not only because they have such an aggressive tri-lane, but also because the Shadow Demon Kunkka is also very, very fun. It's actually very, very difficult to dive at the tower just because, you know, they have Torrent, they have Disruption, there's so much to really stop that. And looks like 1437 does find this Vino. CM's coming.
This happened a little bit last time where Mouse Balls were inside the middle lane. We were almost at the point where at 140, I think, was when the game crashed, where Mini Boy was looking to try and engage through the side, and Shadow Demon threw down a wall to see it. Fishbone now trying to go up and Sing Sing. But with that support of 1437, it makes it almost impossible to find really a good gank, not unless Mini Boy lands the Gale of his life, which you'll now get on 1437. CM throws it an over as well. Waga with the spin might be enough, wants to go for the disruption and denial out by Kunkka. Well, the double damage room makes it way too easy for that to happen. Now, Venomancer tick over made that possible.
Oh, he probably could have been able to get that CM since his Tidebringer was up had he landed that Torrent. But there's just going to be so much action, whereas our side lanes are going to be fairly passive. We're going to most likely see Tide maxing up Anchor Smash for those Broodlings. And then, of course, Black and Bounty Hunter are going to have, you know, kind of an exchange bottom. I think that the Sand King definitely has a little bit of a advantage just because Caustic is very hard to deal with Bounty Hunter.
That's the reason why he's leveled up to level 2. Bounty Hunter wants to get in close, and then all of a sudden, corpses explode everywhere around you. And life is hard. Bamboo might be in a little bit of trouble here on the top lane. Anchor Smash started off, but there's no mana for a Gale, so it's not going to be enough to try and bring him down. I don't know if you also noticed, too, where Enigma's been staying the entire game. Come with me, has not wanted to leave the dire jungle. Just realizing that it's just not safe in his own jungle, not with a Venomancer and a CM rotating around looking for kills. So he's just hung up there inside the dire jungle, keeps farming up, and none of the infused guys are going to realize where he is just yet.
Not yet. I think it's really, I think it's really cool to see that Infused is so mobile. You know, they've been all over the map. They started bottom, they went middle, got a couple of kills. You know, they're transitioning top already. You know, it's only 2 minutes in.
And top lane. I'm waiting for Come With Me to come out, and he is going to do so. He's looking for Mini Boy. Sand King's killing up Bounty Hunter in the meantime on the bottom lane. They'll stick with Mini Boy in the top lane because they might now go for Region, who is on the run back out from Bamboo. They got to get a little bit more of a slow. Malphasun still on cooldown for a little bit. And Come With Me can't really sacrifice anything more there of his life through the Soul Ring to get those stuns off, or else he'll end up losing his life to that Tidehunter.
He definitely will. And then bottom, we just see how powerful the Caustic is. That's just so, so very difficult to deal with, especially...
Mid lane. We're going, again, it's an easy combo. Disruption into the Torrent. However, that good spin out from Waga does a lot of damage to 1437, and 1437 trying to run away from Waga Mama, but Sing Sing body blocking him off.
Yeah, that was a great block by Sing. It's interesting to see that Waga Mama is getting a level of healing ward so early. Usually you only see that with push. I think it's very, very prevalent in the American teams that play Jug. Mostly Jao comes to mind from Complexity. And they just go, you know, straight up push. I don't think that's something they're going to do with this team just because they don't have all that much pushing power. They have Vino wards, but that's really it. So, interesting to see that he picks that up so early.
For those who are tuning into Dota TV and wondering why the sound is not working inside the game, I have no idea. You guys can see that little comment box on the right-hand side showing that it should be available. But for some reason, yeah, it is not displaying to the world of Dota TV. No idea why. It should be working, but it is not. I'll try resetting it up for those people out there, but we'll wait for just a moment when maybe Warg is not going to die in the mid lane.
I think he's playing really passive right now. He has a spin up. It'll be very difficult for him to die, especially because, you know, he's just waiting for his bottle to come back with his crow. Vino did smoke up, so maybe we're going to see them go for a kill here. CM's coming from bottom.
Yeah, they need that good opening, and they're going to find it too. The Gale is going to be right lined up there for Mini Boy. Gets it all 1-4-3-7, so the support area to bring him down should be easy enough. Again, Sankin killing a bounty hunter while everyone else is engaging in other lanes. 1-4-3-7, Frost is up. Nice little turn there by Singh. Angus, the denial again. So double time denial out in the Shadow Demon, which means Mousesports end up actually taking that technically 1-0.
I mean, I don't really necessarily think that I would tally it 1-0, but it's definitely good for them because they use all of their spells. They use so much mana. On the Hero Lake Jug, you know, it's not that bad because he is bottle crowing, but, you know, for CM and Vino, you know, that's very, very destructive, especially because, you know, they did use one of those precious early smokes. Oh, that's on an 8-minute cooldown. Right now, Sand King is level 7, and our Bounty Hunter is level 5. It's going to be very, very difficult for him to be able to catch up if Black does not transition.
Black is currently hunting on the bottom lane until he gets completely caught out. There's no track, but there's a Burrow strike through and two right clicks. It might be enough. Actually, he needs three to do so. Dan, that was the longest third right click I've ever seen. And Bounty Hunter, he needs one toss and has one toss and finally ends Black's killing spree on the bottom lane.
Meanwhile, top lane, Bambo's very low. He knows that there's a sentry there. But this Tide, he's just trying to deal with all the spiderlings on him, but he doesn't want to use his anchor smash because he wants to save it in case Bambo does come in range, but it doesn't look like he's going to do that. So Broodmother doing a really great job of keeping the Tide back, knowing that the Tide's on low mana.
It's the best thing you can do, use your spiderlings where your body can't do the job. And the sentry ward's going to die in a couple of moments as well, so Tide's going to lose the vision. In fact, there it goes now. So Regen, you see him instantly make a move back to that tier 1 tower. Just not 100% sure where that Broodmother is, and the Broodmother, it's only a level 1 web, which is really, really surprising for a Broodmother. He's decided to go 1 point into Insatiable Hunger, and again, Black killing off the Bounty Hunter. Come with me, looks like he helped out with one Malifaux stun. But that is all. No Black Hole,
yeah,
no nothing like that.
He had the dust as well.
Okay. Sing Sing now in a little bit of trouble. Frost is there, and also the Frostbite. The structure from 1-4-3-7 will get Sing back out of trouble. Gale will fly. Ward also blocks him for a moment. He has to turn up his sleeve, but he needs to bring Infuse into a very small area here until Waga just pops the ulti to make sure Sing Sing does take a fall. Well, now they're looking for Mini Boy. Support trying to rotate. Now, come with me, won't get there in time. But 1-4-3-7, what? Mini Boy walked back into it.
Yeah, I think his pathing probably messed up. Either that or he was scared of Come With Me coming out of the jungle, but most likely I think it was a pathing error since he kind of stuttered before he went back. You know, I mean, obviously, Malice has taken some, you know, fatalities in the middle lane.
Oh, Waga. Real trouble in middle lane. I don't know if he just stopped controlling himself just then. But he got disrupted up and then Come With Me TP's in and then follows up with a stun, and Waga just dot dot dots that.
Yeah. I don't think he was expecting that. Maybe it was Dota 2 error, since I know that's been pretty prevalent this morning. Malice is doing a great job, though, of, you know, controlling this tri-lane. They are giving up a few deaths, but, you know, Sing Sing does have both of those denies. And it's just very, very difficult. Every single time they go in for a kill, the Vino and the CM usually have to go back and heal. Mm-hmm. So. And they're going on black bottom.
Yeah, it's a long dive.
So.
It's a long, long dive in. Wonderful ward out there by Mini, but Donny, he's trying to find him. Dust will pop off. Come with me, needs that stun. He's going to pop the black hole, but there needs to be more support TPing down here. 1-4-3-7 came in to help out, but Regen's currently going to chase him down towards the tower. Anger smash and two right clicks should do the job. Shadow Demon actually killing off the Crystal Maiden out of all of that. And still, Bounty Hunter hiding down here. Ravage will pop up from Regen. Buys him some space on Come With Me, and that'll be his death as well.
Yeah, I think that Malice kind of had a little bit of a misplay there, just where they weren't really focusing anyone. Like, 1437 went down the lane, purred to the CM, trying to get the CM kill, whereas Come With Me, you know, thought that he'd get the hole off before the Sand King died, and maybe the Sand King could pop Epi or stun or do something to burst that Bounty Hunter down real quick, but it didn't happen, so it does look like it's going to be the death of the T1 tower. Either that or some extreme damage on it.
While that happens, Tier 1 tower on the top lane goes down. They've brought a lot of people down here from Mouse Sports towards the bottom lane. We saw Region coming in, popping that Ravage. But he was the one that was holding Bamboo back. You never want to give a Broodmother some space, and they're going to give Broodmother a little bit more to go with. It's come with me, goes up towards the top lane. So Enigma will return. And they might even look for the kill on the Tidehunter, keeping coming inside the jungle for the most part. And then Bamboo, just the burst damage out from those two will be more than enough. And actually, they're going to find Fishbone a long way from home. Well, actually, not really a long way from home, but Sam Bamboo is a long way from home. But they want the Tide. Tide, they know his Ravage is down. This is the time to initiate. Anchor Smash or not, he will still get stunned. And those Spiraling damage should be enough. 14 HP. Bamboo just wants one set of Spiralings into him. 1 second, 0 seconds. Now he can do the job. And those Spiralings will turn onto the Crystal Maiden.
And, yeah, they have no reveal on the Dire side besides the Bounty Hunter ult, so Bamboo is safe for now. It's also interesting to see that Mouth has absolutely no vision in this map. You'd think, you know, in a game like this where they have, you know, a CM, Fishbone, a Vino, and a Bounty Hunter.
It was so easily prepped by Bamboo. He needs to go invis again before he gets tracked, which he does successfully do so.
He's just hanging back there and waiting for his moment to strike.
He was harassing CM, even in range of the Tier 1 tower. He just had the Spiraling just bringing her points down. And considering she's only got 587, and then you got level 4 Spiralings to fire in, the damage was more than enough to kill off the CM. It's all about finding your prey.
Black is just farming so well right now. That caustic is serving him very well. I believe he's the highest level in the game. He's level 10, matching with the Brood. So, you know, the experience graph is probably going to be way in the favor of Mouse, just because, you know, they do have that Enigma sitting there being a bank. When Enigma's not messed with, he can get a mech in around 6-7 minutes, which is really
wow,
huge.
That is one big fail boat by Singh. He wanted to prep with Kamamiyu's body blocking Wagamama. They gotta be careful. Waga's got ulti. He's gonna pop it too with Bounty under here, throwing out the toss. Waga's almost gone. Singh needs one last right click as 1437 just disrupts to keep him alive. And oh, Singh, I love the angle. I love the angle. Ravage is going to pop off from Tidy. They're going to kill off Come With Me. I want to go back to what Singh did in a moment. After Dhoni is trying to finish off here with Singh, track will go, but they just cannot catch up to him in time. But Singh realized he couldn't catch up to Juggernaut, not just by normal running, so what he did was just right-click one of the creeps that was nearby him, and Tidebringer did finish the job.
Yeah, I also want to just mention that 1437 had a really, really, really great disruption. There is actually a projectile in the air about to kill the Enigma when he put him under, so that saved his life and bought him a couple more seconds before he died, and so Tide actually had to pop his Ravage there, so that was a great bait out by Mouse.
How are we looking as far as our transition goes now? We see Yasha going up on the Broodmother, so Bamboo doing that aggressive kind of style he likes to with the Manda style on the Brood. On bottom lane, Bam, Black going right on top of Dhoni. The dust has popped off, so they know exactly where he's going to go. And with the AP Center combined, it should be enough damage. Bottle Charges as well as Stick Charges trying to keep Bounty Hunter alive a little bit longer. But not enough in the end, and Black looking for another Burrow Strike. He wants Fishbone, easiest one to kill. But it is, in fact, Mini who gets himself into a bad position. Region going down the top lane in the meantime. Sunstrom Come With Me helping out. Caustic Finale, Come With Me getting frostbitten up there a little bit. And the tower will do a decent chunk of damage. But having that mech there as well as the Buckler gives him the armor to survive. Looks like 1437 and Bamboo teamed up together to get that kill on top.
Mouse is doing a really good job of controlling this game. We kind of knew that they would have a little bit of an advantage with the Enigma and the Brood as far as early game goes. That's the risky run when you have two roaming heroes with CM and Vino. You know, they're very, very low on the experience. Obviously, Crystal Maiden sitting at 5, Vino at 6. So it's going to be kind of difficult for them to transition into the early mid, even though technically with their tri-lane they should have been a little bit stronger. I think that Sing Sing and 1437 did a really good job of keeping their kills to a very, very low minimum and using that Gale to their advantage by keeping the denies up. So right now, even though, you know, technically the Juggernaut CM Vino lane should have just absolutely decimated middle, the combination of a very, very defensive oriented lane with the Shadow Demon, and the fact that, you know, Sing Sing was just on the ball as far as picking off those denies kept this Juggernaut from being a huge problem.
Mm-hmm. We're going to see Bounty Hunter being in huge trouble, from a huge problem with just two heroes, 1437 and Bamboo there. And the Spiraling Charges and Disruption and the Curse, it's all they really need to get those kills off. And Bounty Hunter getting caught out. This is not what he really wants. Sends him back a long way with his farm, and that's now the fifth death here for Dhoni. He's only got 41 for 2, and that's really not helping him off. Region trying to get in close. Black is here as well. No epicenter for him. Those conversions. Still doing some damage to the Tidehunter, but being level 11, tanky as hell. Ravage will pop. Oh, Region. He really, 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 really wanted that stun out on Black. Or come with me, and now they'll turn around. Come with me, still got Black Hole. So he's thinking, you know what? Why not? Let's go for this. 6 seconds. Epicenter will be up then. Black still with that Burrow Strike and get through 2 right now, but decides not to use it. Now he's going to go Burrow Striking in on the Tidehunter into the Epicenter. While Region's held there, Fishbone will disintegrate as well. Double kill for Black. Bounty Hunter comes in and Wyger popping his ultimate off, killing off the Enigma. The Black just blinked himself away to safety on the run. They do have the tracks. They know where he is. They didn't get that right click on him, so Black's blink deck and never went to cooldown. And also, while that happens, top lane Mousepaw's pushing on the tier 2.
Yeah, it's hard right now. It's just gonna kind of be like a snowball right now, just because, you know, you can't leave Sing Sing alone to free farm in the middle lane. You can't leave Brood alone to push in the top lane, and they're losing the bottom fights with the numbers. I mean, you know, they had 3 heroes there as opposed to 2, but you know, they're just not transitioning all that well into the mid game. I think as far as the Tide, I think he thought that he could catch up to them for the Ravage because Black was tracked, and obviously that gives him move speed bonus, but it wore out a second before he popped his Ravage, so he did lag behind there. So I think that's kind of what happened with that Ravage, for those who were wondering.
Okay, in middle lane, Crystal Maiden about to be destroyed. Tauren as well as just a right click from Kunkka with that 4 on Tidebringer. Yeah, just way too much damage for anyone to really withstand, especially a Crystal Maiden. And they're going to push down the middle lane. Broodmother finishes up his mana style, and he's already disintegrated that top area. So he'll start looking at Arax next. And meanwhile, on the bottom lane, Black just keeps farming that up. Bounty Hunter can't get close, and Infuse is going to try and defend up this middle lane. Disruption as well as catch from 1437. Gosh, and the ship flying in here from Sing Sing. Wyger wants to have a crack at this, spinning him around, going on, come with me. But Gale also, well, the oldie pops off for a mini boy, and they're trying to catch out Sing Sing. And Wyger actually leaving, come with me. The mech will pop off from him, and it gives him a little bit more life to try and survive. Black has now joined the fight as well. Double kill for the Bounty Hunter. Now going to track up on 1437. Black trying to return, being dusted up. He needs a Burrow Strike and get away from here as fast as he possibly can. 1437, catch it goes again, but a great ward there by Mini, holding Black in place. A Bounty Hunter now with a triple kill, he needs a stun or something, but doesn't have it, so SD able to TB out again. But Bamboo now going to join the engagement, but he's getting half blocked in right now. All he really wants is the kill on Mini, but he's not going to find it. And he can't find Bounty Hunter because he went back inside his Ghost Walk or Shadow Walk.
Yeah, you know, it is worthwhile to say that it's going to, you know, as hard as it is right now for them, if they get a couple of pickoffs, a couple of good engagements, they're definitely still in this game. That's the power of track gold. You know, you get 2 or 3 kills with level 2 track, and that's already, like, wiping the entire other team. So, you know, they're definitely not out of this.
Never. Bounty Hunter can turn around any economical disadvantage. The problem he has, though, is he still needs items so he can deal that damage and go hunting. It's one thing to win the money. It's another thing to actually win the experience. And at this point, experience went up to it was over 12k going the way of Mouseports, and only drops down by 1.5k. And the gold doesn't really make that much of a move, but on the bright side for Infuse, it starts to plateau a little bit. 1437 just disintegrates in the middle lane. And that was another track kill, so bonus gold for Region as well as Fishbone.
Yeah, you know, I mean, right now they have almost complete map control just because, you know, they have no tier 1 towers, whereas Mouse has retained all of their towers and tier 2 is taken top. They almost have to dedicate one player to top lane to stop this Brood from just being a constant threat. Looks like they are going to transition top, try to pick off this Broodmother, punish him for coming out so far, but it doesn't... Oh, they do have a dust. They pop the smoke. There is a dust on Vino.
Yep, they're gonna find him.
In they go.
There goes the Nova. Ward being dropped down as well, but Bamboo runs up high. And he goes back down again inside the ward. So they can Gale and Frost him up, but he pops the Crystal Maiden. You gotta remember, he's still got that mana style, so whoever he wants to try and have a crack at, it's difficult to do so. And now 1437 getting ripped up by Dhoni as the Bounty Hunter just doing what he needs to do. Disruption Illusion's going on Wyger, so he's not having a great time. And Insatiable Hunger from Bamboo, he's doing it solo right now. Triple kill for Bamboo. Ravage will pop to try and bring him down, but Tyrant will buy time. Ship as well with a stun, and Bamboo wants to turn back onto the Bounty Hunter. He realizes one toss and he could be dead. But he needs to do some form of damage, and now the mech charge gives him his time to do so. Midnight Pulse just going to add some effects on this one. SK comes in to join the fight. And Infuse losing four on that top lane. Bamboo's showing where all that farm goes into.
Yeah, they used so many spells trying to bring down that Brood, and he manted out of one, then he just escaped out of the other. It was very, very great of him to bait all of those spells and then buy time for his entire team to get there and wipe the dire side. So it's just showing what map control and the experience difference really does for them. And this SK, he's so tanked up right now. He has a cloak, he has a vanguard, and obviously, you know, he has his core items with the blink and the arcane boots. So, you know, he's pretty much set. It's interesting to see what he's going to go next, but for 20 minutes, that Sand King is going to be close to unstoppable unless the rest of his team goes down first and, you know, there's four heroes on him trying to pick him off at the end. Looks like they are going to try to put some pressure on bottom.
Let's also see what Black wants to go. Like, you're talking about what kind of build he wants to do. And Black, his whole thing is, wow, really? Did Brewmother get brought down the top lane? You know, Wagamama or ulti can do that job for you. But Black, if he decides to go aggressive and go down the Shiva's guidelines, or if he decides, you know what, maybe I'll just do it for my team, get that hood so he can go inside the base, try and deal with any type of damage which will be done from Infused as we go in. Already got mech, got that pipe, have drums, all the extra items just come up for him.
Yeah, I think this is a game where the Radiant lineup is definitely going to have to get a pipe. You know, they just have so much magic damage between the Ravage and the CM and the Vino. You know, CM and Vino alone actually do much more damage than people, you know, really give them credit for if they land their spells. You know, Vino ult is actually very, very devastating. So they are going to need a pipe at some point in this game. It looks like that probably could be what Black is going for. He has the cloak right now. He's sitting on 2.8k gold. So we'll know in about 300 gold if that's what he wants to pick up in its entirety.
I'd like a quick pipe. Mouse balls. So really, they've got to go on the front foot, and they'll let them do it. They've already taken out all the outer towers for Infused and haven't lost a single one of theirs. In fact, has any real damage been done to it? Bottom lane is the weakest one of it, sitting at maybe one third of its normal life points. The mouse balls, they've got the map control. They've got the map control down pat. Bamboo is now rotated out from the top. I think he's realized too, he doesn't really need to be there. He wants to be closer as well, close to his teammates, as well as closer towards both the lanes in case he's got to rotate. That way they can push in on the bottom lane, push in through the middle lane.
Bounty Hunter picks up a gem as well as BKB. So, you know, I think right now all he's really concerned with is staying alive and getting that track off and helping his team turn around this economic, you know, crisis they're in, kind of get them out of a rut. So he's going to be playing much more carefully, and now that he has BKB, it's going to be very, very difficult for Maus to burst him down.
Brace yourself right now. Moving. Tracked out and Bamboo. Gush as well falling out from region, so they realize that Roshan's being done. 1437, still got that sentry ward there, so Bounty Hunter wants to try and run around here. He's not going to be able to, but they've got the gem, so they send Juggernaut towards the front lines to try and get rid of it, and he does do so. And that's to spin himself back out again, while Singh as well as Bamboo go back inside the Rosh pit. Bamboo popped that Mana Star, so he managed to disperse off the track. Nova will fly out again, so Infuse still with the high ground, popping off the dust. 1437 disrupts himself, so he avoids the gale. Currently a long, long way away, holding region out. Ship's going to make a bit of a fly, but no one's there to be hit by it. Black trying to look for an opening as well, but this whole thing is just split up. Ravage will pop. Same time CM goes down. Wyga jumps around in his ultimate as Bamboo is able to get around it. But Sing Sing in the meantime, he went completely uncontested, picked up the Roshan, took away the Aegis the Immortal, as Come With Me will be brought down by the rest of Infuse, and Sing Sing with a double damage is going to destroy that Bounty Hunter. If he gets enough right clicks in, Aegis the Immortal is going to pop off in a couple moments' time when they finally bring him down, but Black going to come in, Burrow strikes through, buys the time, they pick up the support heroes, double kill now, triple kill in fact for Bamboo, picking up three, and they're going to make a beeline for the middle lane with so many heroes down, not to mention Dhoni, who is limping himself away. That BKB was the only thing that kept him alive during that engagement.
Yeah, that was I'm not really sure if they intended to do it, but they kind of all, the mouse boards here was kind of all scattered south into, you know, up those ramps and into that jungle and down that river, while Sing Sing grabbed a double damage rune and just finished off the Roshan. So, you know, overall that was just almost as perfect as they could have asked for, almost team wiping the dire side, making sure that, you know, all those big spells were used. They have no Ravage, they have no Vino ults, etc. And now, you know, they go pretty much uncontested to take these racks.
Well, looks like Wagga kind of wants to contest a little bit. They've taken down the tier 3 tower. TP coming out from Tide instantly. Bamboo is a long, long way in. He should not be there. Disruption will buy him some time. Sing Sing popping that ship again. Fishbone got to get a little bit further away, but Bamboo just on the hunt. Now he's going to go for the Bounty Hunter with BKB or not. That Hunger still wants to go through. Burrow Strike in from Black, holding Juggernaut in place and long enough to kill him off. Now Region also takes a fall with Bamboo chasing him down, but a Shadow Demon's Curse that helps to get the last point in. Now Bamboo pops the Manda, dispelling off the track again. Wagga tries to spin. Bamboo, he needs a little bit more life to try and live through this. He's basically just leeching it out. Wagga's going to go, well, maybe he'll live through this one. The Curse just hold him out of that play. They're still going to get that mid racks. Meanwhile, on bottom lane, Mini Boy. Bamboo kills off the gem. Mini Boy wants to come back in again for Bamboo. He's on low life, and there's the Juggernaut bounce around. Got a lot of lucky hits in there on Bamboo until he gets disrupted, now stunned, now torrented. He spins away, but Epicenter in from Black just disintegrates the support heroes. And GG, well played, comes out from the Infused Boys as Venomancer will DC out. Remember, there's still the time ranking in this. But it is going to be Infused completely DCing out, making their end results for the group stage being 2-3.
You know, for this game, I'm going to have to give the quote-unquote MVP award to 1437. He's had just so many really, really great disruptions. I'm not sure if you caught it, but he disrupted the Broodmother to save him twice during that last fight. So, you know, Insatiable Hunger with the Manta, he was able to turn around and go back in and fight up. And so, you know, I think he had a very, very difficult lane. Obviously, and being able, and he had to give up the first blood because of what happened before the remake. So, you know, he did a really good job of protecting his Kunkka, making sure that they didn't lose too much in that middle game, and keeping his team alive during fights.
Mm-hmm. That's the great role of a Shadow Demon. That's the reason why he's really one of those big pickers now. Big picked heroes inside the game of Dota 2. For a while there, he was a little bit ignored. And now they realize just how important it is. Keep those key heroes up, just that disruption when a team tries to engage. Sing Sing's actually going to take a fall right now, if not, come with me. Gets three into the black hole. It's pretty easy too, because there's only one person who is still microing all these guys up, and that is Dhoni. He's the only one left inside the game right now. But he still wants to bring out the chain of heroes. Doesn't care how many kills pop off, as long as he's able to maybe kill come with me, or maybe just stall up the Mouseball's push as they try to win for a good ranking time. And Dhoni's going to kill off Kamami. The dust pops, man. The timing for that one. Disruption as well. Burrow Strike. There is just nothing he could do from that point. They can go back to finishing what they were doing. How many ships has Sing managed to use this game? So that's going to be GG. Coming up next, our games for this evening. We're going to have the Empire going up against Na'Vi. So Na'Vi get to play in their second game here for the defense and maybe be able to claim their first win. At this point, they've actually got one loss to their name, which is not really what a lot of people expected when Na'Vi came into the defense. But yep, Na'Vi coming up in just a couple of moments' time up against the Empire. Who will reign? You will find out. See you soon.
I said good day, sir!